In this video, I'm going to show you how I made this Christmas tree. It's not only made of sewer pipes, but it's also a really cool vertical hydroponic system. Of course, it's not very practical because it's really hard to maintain, but it's a great Christmas present. Let's start with a protein powder container. It's important that it's not translucent because light can trigger algae growth. I'm drilling a hole in it for a 110 mm sewer pipe adapter to fit in. And apparently it's not wide enough, so I have to cut it with a Dremel. Then I just clean everything up with a utility knife. It fits! The tree itself is quite big, so I have to glue it to the container lid. Yeah, super glue wasn't a very good idea. Hot glue is much better choice. It's not going anywhere. Here I'm drilling a hole for a 12 volts connector, because we need a pump inside to distribute all the nutrient solution to the plants. It's a really snug fit without any adhesives. I'm adding a 110 mm pipe inside to make the structure more stable, so it can stand on the bottom of the container. It doesn't fit inside, so I have to cut the wide part off. What a champion! Cuts the pipe holding it with his stripy socks. Oh yeah, baby. Don't forget to sand all the debris, because it can clog the nozzles that we are going to add later. Okay, now it's too long. So yes, prepare for the stripy socks once again. Here they are. I'm using some electric tape to make it tight. Good. I'm drilling several holes to equalize water and air pressure later on. I'm trying to make a sponge water filter for the nutrient solution flowing down, but it's going to fail because the roots are too long and they just penetrate through the filter. I use this $5 water pump to deliver the solution. I'm connecting it to the power adapter and to the water tube with a hose clamp. It's 9 mm inner diameter tube. And again, look at him, using hot glue instead of liquid tape. That's the hero we all deserve. Let's put the pump into the pipe. And now I'm cutting the tube, so I can use a four-way connector on the first layer of our tree. I 3D printed all the connectors. It's much easier to print all the tubes vertically and then glue them together with a CA glue, because the layer lines inevitably leak if water passes along them. This is a very scientific way to check if it leaks. Yeah, this one is fine. I widen holes in the nozzles with a pin. Of course, you don't have to 3D print anything, it works just fine with a hole in the tube and a four-way connector from Home Depot. It's just our local stores don't have any of these. Then, one by one, I'm cutting the tube to the size, installing the nozzles. If you wonder why I'm talking you through all the obvious steps, it's because I have no idea how to choose good music for my videos. So deal with it. Yeah, it's completely broken. I use a pass-through nozzle in the middle, but again, you don't have to, just poke the holes in the tube. Let's test how it works. Seems alright. Now it looks like a tentacle monster, but bear with me. And apparently there is not enough pressure to get the water to the top. It doesn't go higher than this. Okay, at this moment I thought that the project is a complete failure. But the solution is really simple, just print more pink dildos with less holes in them. Just one hole per nozzle and it works. Clogging could be a concern though. Yeah, it goes to the very top. And this is how it looks with the new connectors. Let's put everything together. Still no music. I use General Hydroponics Maxi Grow because it's pretty cheap and very easy to use. Just 1 teaspoon per gallon of filtered water. I'm putting the top on. And it's about time to put the plants in. I have some leafy greens here. Chives, arugula, lettuce, dill, parsley, basil, and also some sugar peas. 30 in total. I planted them directly into rock wool. I tried rock wool that is used for insulation, but it appeared to be water resistant, so I had to buy the proper one. I printed my net pots myself. I think these big holes work better than the smaller ones. And it's even cheaper than those bought on eBay. I just put the plants into the net pots and then into the system. When the plants grow bigger, they fill all the space inside the pipes and there is no way to get them out without damaging the roots. So yeah, it's more like a Christmas present and not a real production system. There's a lot of hydroponic system types, but this one should be probably called nutrient film technique or low pressure aeroponics, because the roots are in the chamber where they have a flow of nutrient solution. Sometimes we all need some good luck cuddle. I'm so happy to hear it circulating the solution, but I still have no idea if it works well for the plants. This is how it looks after 10 days. That's promising. Here's my lettuce, basil, dill, and sugar peas. Four more days later, it looks even better. Look at these roots. This basil tried to flower, so I had to pinch off the top. Look how big it is. This lettuce also deserves to be cut a bit. I use these 200 watt soft boxes because we don't have enough sunlight in winter. Another 5 days later. I've already added another gallon of water, so I have to check the solution. It appears to be basic and really unsaturated. So I am adding another spoon of fertilizer, some hydrogen peroxide and water. Much better now. Look, the roots are already at the pump. I didn't expect that. In 2 days I decided to prune my basil. It has a really strong lemon taste. This is how it looks 1 month after I built it. I had to prune these roots in the bottom chamber. They grow so fast and they can clog the pump. I asked my mom to accept my present earlier, so you could watch this video before Christmas.
We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year! Новогодняя ёлка тебе.
Из канализационных
труб.
С ума сойти.
Помидоры.
Вы сумасшедшие люди. Вы такие вещи
это
делаете.
Это папа.
Смотри, как я его люблю сильно. Ой, ты мой зайчик, я тебя 100 лет не видела.
I hope you enjoyed this video as much as she enjoyed the present. Please like or dislike. Implement it at home and comment about your results. Subscribe to the channel to see more crazy DIY things. See ya!